Good morning, Vancouver. It's another hot one out there today.
Scientists confirm that global temperatures have risen dramatically over the last 3 years.
Flooding continues worldwide as the UN struggles to contain the worldwide disaster.
With resources becoming increasingly scarce, we're slipping ever closer to another global conflict.
This city has never seen a level of violence like this before.
All this after 12 straight days of rioting, which is still consuming.
Major flood walls are being expanded and fortified to surround and protect what is now being called Sector 1.
Crime and violence still a major concern.
Helix has been dubbed as the best weapon yet.
Helix has slashed the city's unsolved crime.
All has created a two-tier system.
No outsiders to the Vancouver Free Territory. That is the beauty of the wall, and the perfect Helix system.
No. Where's my photo? No.
Don't you know not to run from a cop?
Cop? That's a joke. You're a freaking security guard. Would you get your mama to sew those badges on?
Activate.
My hands. I can't move my hands.
And your nerve cuffs would be fine.
Don't you leave me like this, man.
So you're like some kind of guard or something?
I'm a cop or something.
Officer Magnuson, reporting a break-in. It's my attic. They cleaned me out. Can you help?
So what is the problem? You got broken into?
Yeah.
Where do you live?
Old Kits. Did that guy have any photos on him?
Look, you live in Sector 3. It's not my area. Contact your local police.
We don't have any cops.
Listen, I'm sorry about your place, your photos or whatever. Take this. It's a lot of money. And just be careful.
And he ran away.
Oh, hey, Ellie. You're here, huh?
Barrett? I'll be over there when you're done.
Oh, come on. Impressive. I'll have to remember that. I finally have a use for you.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
No.
Sugar?
Hey, Captain.
What can I get you?
I will grab a bottle of your finest.
A bottle? Well, hey now, Mr. Big Spender, huh?
It's been a great day for the Get Aiden Over the Wall Fund, and I am celebrating.
Really?
Why would you want to go there? It's awful.
It's awful?
Do tell.
My aunt lived there up until last year, and she told me all about it. Besides, wouldn't want to leave us all alone here, do you?
Hey, baby.
Don't bother. I'm a cop.
Oh, well, he's a cop. Well, cops have lots of money, sugar. Mm-hmm. Nice government job.
Ow! And who can resist a man in uniform?
Oh!
Back to work.
Thank you.
Stop! Freeze!
Here called it in. He's Sector 2, one of their community security projects.
Great. Grant a hero.
Oh, and he's been drinking.
Sir, Officer Aiden Magnuson, Sector 2 Police, City Corps Division.
Officer Magnuson? Thank you for your hard work.
Sir, you see, I saw some tattoos and some scarring.
Mr. Magnuson, thanks for your help, but we really need to clear the crime scene. There's important police matters to attend to. I'm sure you understand.
Okay, yeah, but let's not pretend this is the first time we're seeing someone like Voltano being caught over there. This is just a case that had a tragic outcome.
Case disgusting. Is disgusting. The whole place is disgusting.
All right. I think we can see where you stand. Thank you, caller. For those of you just joining us, we are discussing the arrest of Councilman Nicholas Voltano last night for an apparent murder in Sector 2. Our next caller is...
Transfer funds.
...from Sector 2. Good morning, caller.
Hi, Zap here.
Thanks.
Suzanne. You can call me Susie or Anne, but don't call me Sue or I'll kill you.
All right, Suzanne. I gotta get going. It's nice to meet you. Thanks.
You are busted. Might as well go to his office right now. The leather man beckons.
It's inside?
Nah. He just left. You wait inside, young man. He'll be back to tan your hide in just 1 minute.
Shut up and sit down.
If this is about that guy with the cash, it's not the same thing as last time. Is this about last night? Because Sector 1 came in there, and they...
Save it. You're on night shift.
But sir, can we talk about this? I don't even know why
I'm
here.
You've been upgraded.
What?
What is this shit? You've been upgraded. Yeah, you lucky son of a bitch. That, situation you called in last night or something, man. You won the lottery. It's your golden ticket. Some politician, some damn thing. You're a total bastard. Oh, man. Cold water, hot water, clean clothes, clean women. Oh, the pussy they keep behind that wall. Where was I? Oh, yeah. The pussy.
The
I don't even need to ask.
What about you, Mr. Fancy? What's your business here?
I'm here for a job. With the police.
Applications from Sector 2 are not taken at the border. No exceptions.
Sir, I already have the job. I'm just reporting for duty.
Do you have any documents?
Speak up.
No, sir. They did not give me any documents. It should be on my Helix, though.
Must have plenty of time to waste in line. Waste enough of my time, that's for sure.
Please remove all metallic objects.
You gotta see this one. Oh, dude. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Please stop. Please have your arms raised and your legs apart.
Yeah. Turn it around. Mm-hmm.
What's the problem now? That's the guy from the news.
Level 9 processing will be moved to level 7 until further notice.
So you're the super cop. Come to clean up our city too, huh?
Yes, sir. Another one for the collection.
Check out those.
Oh! 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 Please move on, sir. Thank you.
Magnuson? Officer Aiden Magnuson?
Hello, officer.
So I'm Victory Matthews. I'm the publicist for a fine Vancouver Police Department.
Your name is Victory?
My parents were a bit optimistic. Just call me Vic, all right? We've got to bring you right to the station. Maybe a quick stop for some new clothes. I'm dressed you anyways. My mother?
Listen, this kid is photogenic. He's been on the news all night.
No.
We are in an election cycle right now. So, unless you want to lose this one for us, you better start working at it and do what it takes.
Where is Victor and that kid? I know. I just want the mayor to get a bit of FaceTime with him beforehand. Play up the father-son feel to this thing, whatever the hell it's becoming. The mayor is waiting over here. I wanted you to meet him before we got this all started, you know, get to know him a bit.
What is this exactly?
Victor, what is he wearing?
Yeah, I don't know. He just showed up looking like that.
Mr. Mayor, sorry we're late. Problems at the border.
So, is this another interview? I mean, I haven't even seen the questions yet. You better have some damn good answers for me.
No, sir. This is the presentation with the young officer. We're at the police hall. The Magnuson boy, sir.
Vic. Magnuson. I knew your father.
Well, that went well. Oh, dear. Girls, can you make him a little more presentable, please?
Who was that exactly?
Christine? She's the mayor's number two. She's his right-hand woman.
Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, members of the press. Who we know are no gentlemen or ladies. Without further ado, Vancouver, your mayor. Ed Brower.
Thank you. Thank you all very much for coming today. Now, before I introduce to you a very bright young man, a shining example of what we do best in this city, I'd like to share with all of you first a little history. Many years ago, our great city went through what I can only describe as a waking nightmare. As those waters rose and swallowed up our lives, those same waters seemed to swallow up our compassion as well. But in those dark days, there were shining lights, those of us such as Dr. Aaron Magnuson, who worked tirelessly to ensure that ordinary people could make the transition to a new reality. And while the doctor and I could seldom agree on the means, we both knew that the end, the single most important end, was to help people like these. And the fact that I can stand here today on stage with the son of my fiercest political opponent is evidence of that. So I would ask you to give a warm welcome to a very brave young man, Mr. Aiden Magnuson.
Aiden, come on up here, son. Now, in recognition for your work in
getting a very dangerous criminal off our streets, we, the citizens of Vancouver Free Territory, commend you and offer you a position with the Central Force in Sector 1. How does it feel to be a hero, son? Kids, I couldn't get them to stop talking back there.
Mr. Mayor, what was your relation to Nicholas Hilton?
Mr. Mayor, what are you going to do now?
Constable Magnuson's had a very long and tiring day, so I think any questions could be left for a little more appropriate time. Thank you all again for coming. Thank you.
Mayor Brown! Mayor Brown! Officer Magnuson! Mayor Brown! Mayor Brown! Mr. Mayor! Excuse me, Mr. Mayor!
Constable Magnuson, what do you think?
Politics. Fucking politicians. But do they think I need more budget? What I don't need is more new recruits.
Sir, actually, I'm on active duty. I was at...
I don't want you here. So you are going to be a quiet little thing. A goldfish. Every now and then I will open your tank and I will feed you. And that's all I will hear from you. And if you cause me or my men any trouble, I will personally drive your sorry ass back to the wall and put you through the door. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Have Constable Mercer and Ms. DeLuke come into my office immediately. Constable Mercer, Corinne. This is Aiden Magnuson. He's our newest recruit.
Hello, Corinne DeLuke.
Hi, I'm Jeff. Heard about you on the news. Welcome.
Mr. Magnuson is a friend of the mayor's. He's formerly Sector 2. Now he has some patrol experience. But I want you two to bring him up to speed on how a real police department functions. Constable?
Yes.
Constable Mercer. I'm assigning Recruit Magnuson to you for guidance and evaluation. Ms. DeLuke is our department coordinator. She'll fill you in on the day-to-day operations of the department and also take care of your lodging situation. All right, let's get going. Stop wasting time here.
This is our forensic lab. Most of our new field equipment is linked into the system, making most of this obsolete.
You mean making me obsolete?
Always trying to find a way, Brian, but you keep hanging on. Dr. Walcott is largely responsible for our citywide cataloging system. Doctor, this is Aiden Magnuson.
Yes, I've read the news. I know who Mr. Magnuson is. Very pleased to meet you. I knew your father. I knew him well. But Corinne, this is much, much more than a catalog system. This is a web that touches all of us. It connects us, keeps us safe. You know, the possibility of a crime going undetected in this city...
Doctor, I know this is all very exciting for you, but Aiden has a lot more to see today.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. You're welcome back anytime. I knew your parents. I knew them very well.
Right through here's the kitchen and the living area. Has everything you'll need. This beautiful city view. It's nice. I think you'll like it here.
Today, an in-depth look at the fallout from the shock arrest of Nicholas Viltano. Aaron Magnuson's anti-wall party falls at the hands of his own son.
Can't get enough of it, huh? This really is bordering on gloating. Follow me, I'll show you the rest.
Garbage bag? Are you telling me you've never run out of clean laundry?
And area we're seeing mainly clear skies and above seasonal temperatures, still 13 degrees right now in the Siouan Chef.
But where did he come from? You know, I'm tempted to think that the mayor has a team of people following his opponents around day and night.
That's
just
ridiculous.
Waiting for them to
That's
slip
ridiculous,
up.
That's ridiculous, Mark. Can't you set politics aside for 1 second and see that this is more than just a petty crime?
I'm just saying it has the hallmarks of something.
Hallmarks? Of what? A movie script?
Let me finish, okay? Now, look, all I'm saying is something doesn't sit right. I think that anyone can look at this grotesque political theater this afternoon and see that something is wrong.
I see some theatrics, but they're not coming from Mayor Brower.
Oh, but who is this guy? Who is he? He's a Sector 2. He's the son of a terrorist.
What?
Think about it.
That's ridiculous.
So what info do we have, aside from his original helix? A work record? We placed a call this afternoon to Sector 2 Force and got a glowing recommendation from a Chief Crespi, and I quote, "Yeah, he's a good kid."
Yeah.
Yeah, hardly fitting for someone who just today was receiving an honor in our city.
Full systems match. Full systems,
Mark.
Oh,
it's not. No, that's a...
No, that means 100% accurate DNA match to all records. That and the eyewitness account of this young hero.
We are discussing the recent shock arrest of Nicholas Viltano.
Have you sent in the arrest order?
Yeah, I'll do that right now.
What is he doing?
Excuse me, please. Officer Magnuson, can we talk?
Yeah, sure.
What are you doing?
This guy here says he saw 5 guys leaving the apartment.
And our guys were scanning here for over an hour and they found 2.
I don't know. He sounds pretty certain he saw 5.
I see. Well, we've already sent in the arrest order. Now, if you want to bring up with the chief when we get back.
File an alternate report.
It's not necessary. I mean, he's probably just confused, right?
Thank you very much for your time. Unfortunately, he's new to this force and...
So, bro, you ready to do this or what?
Listen, don't worry, we talked to Mercer. He's not gonna be around. We'll get you into something.
Or someone, whichever you want, huh?
Let's do this.
Hey, aren't you that super cop guy or whatever? Oh man, that's awesome. I can't believe you're here, man. Can I buy you a drink or Kathy?
Here it is, hey.
Aiden, you have a message.
Ooh, a girly computer, huh? What else do you get under there?
Playback, please.
Aiden! Hey, fools, Barrett. Can you believe I have to call you from the station? You're restricted from my phone.
I know. Why don't you show me?
So you're gonna have to call me next time. Better. Cause you gotta get me up there Friday night or else. Other man won't shut up about it. I'm serious, he's creeping me out. He's looking at me funny. Nah.
Okay now. I pay my taxes. I wanna see what I'm getting for my money. Come on, Aiden. Discipline, obeying orders. Isn't that what you're all about? Drop them. Oh my, you're a cop, Aiden, not a soldier. No need to stand at attention. I know, policeman's ball. Dance, baby, dance. Yeah, perfect. Perfect. Yeah.
What are you doing?
Oh. I got what I came for. Honey, you didn't think we were gonna... Oh. No, you see, this... Here, this is a filth-free zone. Sorry for the misunderstanding. I thought you knew where you came from.
Like we're supposed to believe this super cop couldn't catch Phil Tano himself? The guy's like 50 or something.
Myers? Hamilton?
Mercer? Who's your new partner?
Hey, it's Dr. Funky! So he's your new friend.
We found this little cockroach sneaking through a break in the wall. Like we just wouldn't notice you.
Can you believe this? They're like rats. We get rid of the little ones and the real ones start coming through. This wall isn't doing shit. Man, you can smell her from here. They all stink. It's too bad, though. Looks like she could be a lot of fun if you cleaned her up a bit. A little too much open sewer, if you ask me.
Hey. What are you guys gonna do with this scum?
Scum? You get a load of this guy? I don't know. Yeah, let's get the soap. Maybe we'll just... Hey!
She's not breathing! Mercer, you gotta call a medic or something.
What is this guy's... She's fine, man. Everything will click back on in a minute.
She's not fine. Mercer, call a medic.
I don't know, guys. Maybe we should call a medic.
Our meds don't have time for shit like this. She'll be fine. What the fuck's wrong with you, Jeff?
Oh, nice. Don't look now. You've really got to watch where you drop your pants. I was going to trip you up one day.
Hey, Jeff. If I want to go back to Sector 2 for something, wouldn't that be hard to do?
Well, you've got your police badge, so that might get you across without too much trouble. You know, it's all run off system, so technically, you know...
The Fultano arrest. If I want to take a look, how would I go about doing that?
The Fultano arrest? Why would you want to... Don't worry about it, kid. This will all blow over in a couple of days.
Hey.
Times speed. Stop playback. Resume playback. Enhance scan. Repeat scan. Upload files.
Seeing a ghost?
Huh?
Huh? I like the new cloth. Almost by the badges this time.
Hey, I was trying to help. It's just that you...
Yeah, big help. Big cop. Big pig. I was thinking how you must have helped when I woke up in a pile of rocks out here.
I had nothing to do with that.
Yeah, but you had nothing to undo with it either, did you?
What were you expecting? You just broke through the wall.
Maybe I came to look for you, friend.
Attention. This checkpoint is now closed and will resume processing at 8 a.m. No loitering or early queuing. Counting is prohibited.
Welcome back, Mr. Magnuson.
Keep walking, Constable.
Sir?
Magnuson, how does unauthorized work hour visits over the wall constitute staying out of my hair?
Sorry, sir. I had to grab something from my old place.
All right, little goldfish. That's your first warning. Don't count on a second. Leave, Magnuson!
Oh, hello, Aiden.
Hello, Doctor.
I'm glad you stopped by. Now, what can I help you with?
I'm not sure exactly. Can I ask, have there ever been any kind of incorrect situations with the system?
Well, it appears he is his father's son after all. Aiden, I have worked with this system for 20 years. I have worked on it for over 30 years. And I have never been witness to any problem, as you put it. To put it simply, by gathering bioinformation on everybody
here... I get that. I understand the principle. I think that... I have a video clip here. I'm not sure what kind of analysis you can run on it.
What is it? Where did you get it?
Off the system, standard read.
Uh-huh. You managed to convince the chief to let you do that? Well, that's quite an accomplishment. You may have a bit of that politician in your blood after all.
It's not something to be proud of, I don't think.
Oh, I don't know about that. There are some good ones. Like your parents.
My father was an idiot. Put politics before his family.
Oh, well, now that's not very fair.
But with respect, sir, you didn't have to live out there.
There is nothing on this. No, there are no files on this device.
I don't understand. I tested this.
Well, don't worry. Just go speak to the chief. Bring me another copy, and I'll be happy to look at it again.
Yeah, okay, I'll do that. I gotta get going. Thanks, Doctor.
No, call me Brian. And my door is always open. Aiden, I'm sorry about earlier. I didn't mean to.
Daryl, screen on. Reference Phil Tano. Personal or media files? Is there a Helix sample? Restricted by who?
That information is not available.
Sector 1 access. Aiden, Jasper, 3-4 Echo. Bring up recent arrest files for any city council members.
Bring up over the last 2 years. 3 years. Reference, Aaron and Shelley Magnuson.
I hope you're not just here to tease the guy. That would be cruel and unusual punishment. That is still illegal here, you know.
Don't worry, I won't do anything you guys wouldn't.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. Right over there through that door. Mr. Fultano, you have a visitor. You have 20 minutes.
We won't need him. Mr. Magnuson, I hadn't expected to see you here today. Through accepting medals in my honor?
Mr. Fultano, I just had a few questions about your case.
Yeah, well, I've got a few questions of my own, if you don't mind. Like, what the hell are you doing here? Come here to win yourself another promotion?
No, I've been looking into your file, and I've noticed a few things not quite right.
That's rich. Because I'd say there's a few things that are quite wrong. I'm in prison!
Sir.
Guard!
Sir, I just need your help to understand a few things. Maybe I can help you.
Well, you certainly can't make things much worse, can you?
I looked into the checkpoint records, and it has you passing through several times. The dates and the times match up. So, I need to know from you why you're in Sector 2. It's unusual.
Well, let's just say that there are things that one can do and get out there that would offend our puritanical little city. Is that what Brower wanted to hear? I've never been an idiot.
Guard! Aiden, there is an intruder. Building security has been notified. Calm preset activated. Would you like anything else, sir?
Forget.
Nice, Peters. Be nice.
Hello, Constable Magnuson. How are you feeling?
Good.
So, we've done a quick look through of your place, and the security system to your unit has been compromised. You will have to speak with someone about that. So, that leaves us with a scan.
Guys, can we clear out for a scan here? Thanks.
Now, the process is pretty straightforward. The scanner is connected to the system at all times. There's not much for you to do except drive it, really. Now, first, we do an auto scan. There's some advanced filters to ignore the data from dust, which is mostly dead skin. But otherwise, this picks up everything from fingerprints to hair to blood. Anything the body spits out, this scanner will pick up. So, let me just eliminate the officers and the security. So that leaves us with Valerie Konstoff. Well, that's it. Cooper, can you get an arrest order right away? You guys, let's pack it up. Let Mr. Magnuson get back to it.
Wait a second. I don't understand. Who is this guy?
It's the guy that attacked you.
No, there's no way it was him. Who is he?
Hey, I don't know what you've done. He's Sector 2, that's your turf, right? Low-level gang boss. So, whatever you bring him, got nothing to do with us.
What are we gonna do about security?
What are you worried about? You got your guy. OK,
Okay, guys. Drop your cards. Pick up your socks. Let's get out of here.
Big guys can be strong, too.
And what, he took a little wheeze break after he climbed 22 floors to my balcony?
The system doesn't lie.
Yeah, well, not deliberately, anyways.
Aiden, good to see you. I was afraid last time I had maybe you just... Good, what happened to you?
Oh, yeah, that's, kind of sort of what I'm here about.
What is it?
It's, I need you to find out who that is, or isn't.
Exciting. Allow me to dust off my equipment.
Come on, Doctor. You've got this all polished up for something just like this.
So, are you finding your new home? And your new job, too, I suppose. Boy, you know, that's a lot of sudden change for one person to take.
Actually, I'm going back tonight. I need a little decompression time. Mm-hmm. You're more than welcome to come if you like.
Boy, I haven't been downtown in... must be 15 years. Aiden, it looks like you're the proud owner of one Mr. Valery Konstov. But I don't follow. Who is this man?
Doc, this can't be right.
Well, it's a match under all conditions. There's really no doubt.
You know, to be honest, I'm feeling a little nervous. I hope nobody recognizes me.
This is my old cop shop.
This is a police station, is it? It was never meant to turn out this way. I want you to understand that. You know, when things first started turning for the worse, there was crime. So much crime. Some looting and violence. The wall, or that's what you could have called it at that time. That was just good people, good neighbors, defending their neighborhood. Keeping away all that rampant violence. Your parents were right. They were right. And I know you don't want to hear that.
No. No. I know.
Who is it?
Hi, it's the police. Is this Mrs. Feltano?
Yes? What do you want?
I just had some questions regarding your husband's case.
At this hour? I thought you guys always traveled in pairs.
Yeah,
Oh, you, huh? I suppose you think I should thank you. Well, I won't. You think I didn't know he was seeing those women over there?
That's not why I'm here.
Why don't you go and talk to him yourself? I'm sure he'd give you his undivided attention.
I've been to see your husband, and I need to ask you, what happened to his hand?
Oh, I see. You try and take my life away from me, and now you want me to help you do it for good. I don't think so. His hand was cut open days before you arrested him. So why don't you try and fit that into your little story?
Hey, is there a hospital record?
Go fuck yourself.
Yeah?
I'm here to see Prisoner Fultano again.
Mr. Fultano's not receiving visitors today.
Since when are prisoners making those decisions? I need to see him.
He's restricted access, sir.
I thought you just said he wasn't seeing anyone.
Yeah, well, whatever it is, you're not seeing him.
Doctor. I'm sorry, sir. Can you bring up some files? All the print matches from the Filtano case.
Yeah, sure. Let me get that. Oh, you're in luck. They took several full handprints from the body.
Ha!
What? I don't see anything special.
Yeah, nothing. Filtano sliced up his hand a few days before the arrest. Badly. He's still bandaged up.
But how can you be certain that didn't happen when you were pursuing him? Or even after that?
I checked the hospital. It's on record.
I did an analysis on that sample you gave me. And there's a problem. It's a perfect match. See, our body undergoes constant assault from everything around us. It damages our cells, our DNA. Now, the body continually repairs what it can. But judging by this sample, Konstov has either lived his entire life in a lead box, or he's only a few days old.
I don't understand. Why wouldn't the system pick that up?
The system has to be adaptable. Why would we set it to react when it's a perfect match? This is too good to be true.
So do you think somebody is stealing these infant samples?
I can say with some certainty no. No, the amount of material we gather is 1/100th of what you scraped out from under your fingernails.
Who has access to these samples?
Oh, well, unfortunately, that list would be in the hundreds, even thousands. With official permission, that is.
Who gives us permission?
Well, it would be high-level police officials for police access and high-level city officials for everyone else.
So not you, huh?
No, I can access the samples, but beyond that, I'm purely decoration.
The chief. Hello, Corinne.
Good afternoon, Aiden. What can I do for you?
Actually, there's two things you can do for me, and you gotta choose one. One, let me see who's been accessing Helix samples. Or two, tell me where the chief is today.
Do you have any sort of official request? You know I don't have access to that kind of information.
Come on. You let me peek at the names. You work for the city and the department. All the requests go through you, I know it.
They don't, and I won't.
It's for an important investigation. It's for Dr. Walcott.
I'm sure it is.
All right, then tell me where the chief is.
He's taking the day off. Now that's all you get. If you don't mind,
I have...
This
would be nice.
Goodbye, Mr. Magnuson.
Doctor? Sir.
What the hell are you doing here? This is completely unacceptable. This is my home.
My home!
Sir, I... Whatever this is about can wait until Monday morning when you hand in your badge.
No, sir, can't. The doctor and I found a serious breach in the system.
A breach?
We need your permission to see who's been accessing Helix catalog.
What kind of breach? And why are you here and not one of my senior officers?
No, that's a good question.
Yeah, fair enough. I'm calling security.
Sir! There are innocent people in prison. I know Filtano couldn't have done it. Somebody is using the Helix catalog to fake evidence. The whole system's been compromised.
Mr. Magnuson, what you're telling me is that some, possibly all of the prisoners that we have, are in there because our system is broken?
Yes.
And that it took a washed-up old hack and a second-rate security guard to bring it to the attention of an entire professional police force.
Sir.
Leave, Mr. Magnuson. Leave now, before I have you arrested.
Aiden, it's me, Jeff. Open up.
Constable Mercer is at the door. Would you like me to let him in?
Aiden, this is not a joke. Open up.
All right, Daryl, open up.
Aiden!
Aiden, you have to leave now. They have a warrant out for your arrest.
He actually called me in. What an asshole.
No, Aiden, Dr. Walcott is dead.
What?
And they want you for his murder.
The doctor's dead?
You have to get out of here now. They found his body this afternoon in this place. They came looking for you when you ducked out early this afternoon. You gotta get out of here. Out of Sector 1. And if you can, further.
I can't. They're gonna scan me at every checkpoint. How am I supposed to make it over that wall?
I might be able to get you under it.
You gotta find the man who attacked you. The man with the tattoos. You gotta prove this is a setup.
Is that a cop coming out of our tunnel?
You gotta be kidding me.
Bear, open up, it's me.
Aiden? Is that you, man? Just a sec.
Sure you can stomach our water there, tough guy? Thought I lost you over there, man. What happened? Look, I think I know a spot, all right? You can lay low there, get some sleep, or whatever, all right? Cool. Yeah?
Yeah.
A lot of these higher apartments aren't safe to live in full time, so they just kind of leave them empty. And I happen to have keys for some of them. Check it out. Real keys, remember those? Little getaway from Ellie. Welcome to paradise. Mikasa Sukasa, my man. It's gray, right? All vintage. I found it just sitting here. Nice little trip down memory lane, huh?
Vintage, eh?
Oh yeah, you'll like those. I mean, I'm sure it's nothing compared to the classy ass you've been seeing lately. We'll do in a pinch. All right, I'll let you sleep.
Hey, thanks, Bear.
Yeah, it's nothing.
Aiden.
Friends I was telling you about. Come on, man. You just left me here. I told you I'd get us in there. You didn't leave me any choice. I gotta look after myself, too. And, Ellie's pregnant. You know what? Fuck you.
You think this is funny? Say something!
Stop talking.
Nice, Aiden, real nice. How long have we known each other?
7 years.
Yeah.
Some people up. Sometimes I don't like my job. But today isn't one of those times.
Show the mayor's office.
I'll look into that.
I'm gonna check his pockets. I'm gonna check the other guy.
Oh, shit. I gotta get out of this uniform. Let's get out of here. These guys stink.
search continues for Aiden Magnuson, Sector 1's most disgraced cop.
Here, give it to me. I think I know what it is.
Get out of the city.
I know someone. He'll help us. Okay, cover your nose and mouth with this. This place is loaded with flight.
What's that?
Bug drug.
No, I know it's wrong. Who else you know has time to fuck around in a month? I will give message to the boys and they will take care of it. So you don't have. I'm telling, we find him and I'll fucking kill him myself. It must. I'm sure it's Roman who framed me. I think he works at City Digester. Crap. Oh, okay, get lost.
Yeah, bye-bye. Susie, my little one. So, who is this guy?
This is...
Andrew, hey. Nice to meet you.
Valery Constant.
Valery Constant.
Look, I get already tough day. I don't have time for chit-chat. So, what's bring you here with your friend, Andrew?
Well, we have police trouble.
It's city police.
Oh, no. That's enough. I already get enough trouble with those pigs. I just get from the jail for something I'm not even doing. And I'm not going back. Enough.
Valery, you know I wouldn't ask for something unreasonable.
First of all, I'm not doing any business with anybody who I don't know. In one moment, Mr. Andrew, you'll put your hand here for scanning. Where are you, piece of shit? Ah, there we are. Put your hand here.
Identity. Andrew Spack.
Susie, Your children must go out of city. Since they come here, Mr. Andrew, why not go join the party?
I think I'm just gonna hang out over there.
Susan, take this. For good luck. And Mr. Andrew, you have a nice bracelet.
So, how are we gonna get out of here? I can't swim.
What was that?
Jafar, I was hoping you were gonna tell me.
I saw the face, it wasn't yours.
Still trying to figure that out.
What is that, Aiden?
I don't know. Why don't you ask your friend Bilari? He seemed pretty interested.
Well, if I listened to him, then I wouldn't be here with you.
I don't know what it is, okay? This is the checkpoint you told us to go to, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll go through first. If I get through, maybe you can just follow.
Okay. Take this. Good luck.
Warning. Unreadable helix.
What the? What are you trying to pull?
Mr. Andrew,
you can just go through. We're having problems with the machine tonight, so you can just go through.
Thanks.
You too, Miss Andrew.
Hey, Sue, let's stop. Fireworks. Actually, I remember going to them as a kid. My parents used to take me. It's kind of ironic because it used to mean summer is here. Now that doesn't end either.
They sound nice. Your parents are eating up the explosions. Do they live in the city?
No. They don't live in the city. I grew up with my aunt.
I'm sorry. What happened to them?
Well, they were both very active in community and politics. And when the wall was going up, the bomb went off. Didn't do much to the wall, but my dad got fingered for it. So he had to disappear. I got shipped off to my Aunt Drezzy's. What about you?
Me? I had a photograph of my parents. But I lost that too. But I was raised by my Uncle Bill. I don't even know if he was really my uncle. He was a seagull. Like, wah, wah! Mean, drunk, bastard bird.
Beautiful.
Yeah, well, you didn't have to live without it.
Mm-hmm.
keep going! I told you, I can't swim!
Keep heading east! You'll find them out there!
Find who?
They'll help you find who you're looking for!
Come back!
I can't! I promised I wouldn't go with you, Aiden!
This is insane! Where am I supposed to go?
Go east, Aiden!
Don't move! Don't you go anywhere!
I'm not gonna rob you, but you could be robbing me. I got something you're really gonna like here. That's a little trade secret. Always start with a laugh. I should charge for that little tidbit, but I won't. Perhaps a fine gentleman such as yourself could use an old-fashioned photo album.
Is there a house nearby that you got this from?
Resent it. Yeah, you know, I resent where you're implying.
This house. Is it close to here?
That's about a click down in that direction, but you better go off in that direction. There's an old army supply depot and rations for you. So let's go.
Where's the tattooed man?
Take him outside.
Where'd you get these?
Who gave them to you?
Who the hell is this guy?
Have a look at this.
It's A. Does it stand for Aiden?
Aiden. It's me.
always knew you would come.
Dad, do you know my parents?
Know him? He made us. We were a bunch of disorganized lunatics before he came.
Where is he then?
Valari gave you these.
Mm.
A big man.
Yeah.
We've worked with him before, but not recently. He always seemed a bit more concerned with his own interests. Residents. Frequencies interfere and combine, forcing the salts into specific patterns. So what did Valeri scream at us this time?
Well, it's definitely a map. It's telling us to go here.
What? It's just a garbage dump.
You have to take me. Valeri obviously wants me to go there.
No.
This message was meant for us. Valeri would expect us to eliminate anyone we didn't know carrying them.
That's a digester. I'm not going anywhere near it.
I know where this is. I'll scout it tonight.
Well, I'm going.
What is it that you're doing?
You might need these to get in or out. Or who knows? Small explosives. Your father taught me how to do this.
Candlelight? How long will it take us to get there?
Well, that could take some time.
What the hell is that?
That happens pretty often. The bacteria they created to digest the garbage. But if it gets out, it's pretty much anything. Completely.
That's him.
Yeah, that's Roman. He's a hired gun.
I need to get in there.
We've got to. Valeri has access to information. There's a high value target in there.
I think I might know what that is.
Thank you. Magnuson. Go.
Giving me a fucking headache. Just stay put.
Davis. Wilkinson. Fucking guys, it's leaving the shit out. Wilkinson.
You take the tables, I'll go get the screens.
Get your ass over here! What are those screens doing up? That should be first! Get all those bracelets into preload. I want somebody there ready to dump them if needed. You, I want all set one data purged immediately. Brower, Simmons, Fultano. Get ready to wipe it if I give the order. Actually, stop that. The guys that escaped couldn't have got far. There could be more. I need you to go to the North Chamber. Could you at least fucking nod at me? Get over there now! When you're done in here, make sure everything's locked down, right? All of it! Fucking idiots.
Stop deletion. Cancel. Cancel deletion.
This is becoming a habit showing up like this. Look, I obviously made a big impression on you. You remembered me. I knew you were, and I told you. But really, what the fuck are you doing here? You surprised me. No, I just wanted to discuss this with you. You gotta go ahead and resort to fire. Yeah, I forgot. Super cop. You're a quick little fucker. You butch. Oh.
kid!
You killed Walcott, you son of a bitch!
I didn't kill anyone!
When the order hits, they're already dead. I just make a dream come true.
For who? Williams? Brower? Is it Valari?
Oh, Valari. That piece of shit ain't worth
it. I don't care about this shit. What happened to the doctor? Who's with you in the alleyway? I saw the playback.
Pigs. Cops. Sector 1. You did a good job for him chasing me. Filtano. You even made me work a little.
Why drag me?
Drag? It was an early birthday present for you. A Brower had a hard-on for your pops or something.
It was political!
Expediency.
We took out all those anti-wall pussies.
It's time for a little demo of this digester.
What are you doing? Where are we going?
You don't make the plans, you're of no use to me.
You see my scars, right? You think this scares me?
Hey, Roman, it's Christine. What's going on? Roman.
That's her.
Roman?
Come on.
Can you hear me?
Let me help you.
Roman! Here you are. What's going on out there? Roman, why are we getting alarm alerts? Why are you...
Does that not seem a bit obvious to you? I mean, I'm sure it would lead to a lot of questions using that route.
Don't concern yourself with that. There'll be plenty of questions after the fact, and these will be the least problematic. However, I do think...
Who is it?
I don't know. I left instructions not to be disturbed. Roman!
What? I told him never to come here. Well, let him in before somebody sees him.
Roman says hi.
What do you want?
I just came to return my badge. Oh, show you guys my new toy. Check this out. I've got some lawyers, some city councilmen, and Nicholas Feltano, and Valari Konstov.
Yeah, that's real cute.
Actually, I haven't even shown you the most interesting one. Now, the funny thing is, there's none here for you, Christine. If you want to do some digging around, you know, do a little police work, here's a map.
Aiden, wait!
You don't need to leave your badge. We could really use your help in breaking this case. And I think a new position for you in the city. Detective.
You know, I think your men will continue to do a good job. They don't need any help from a second-rate security guard. Now, if you guys excuse me, I gotta go home.
In recent days, there's been much talk and rumor about a breakdown of the very system which keeps our beloved city safe, the Helix. Now, I wanted to speak to you today to assure you that they are only rumors, that there has been no significant breakdown. But what we have seen is simply an anomaly. Human error has once again reared its head. However, because of the hard work and diligence of our police force, headed by Police Chief Williams, the problem was discovered and dealt with so that it can never, ever happen again. Now, what I want you to remember as we move on from this better and safer than we were before, is that this was not a lapse.